Since Edward Snowden first began his campaign to expose secret dealings at the U.S. National Security Agency. And this week's groundbreaking reforms to the U.S. Patriot Act can be said to mark a victory for his mission. Now, in an op-ed in the New York Times, he praises the changes which restricts the NSA's authority to collect and store data on Americans' phone calls. He writes this, quote, 2 years on, the difference is profound. In a single month, the NSA's invasive call tracking program was declared unlawful by the courts and disowned by Congress. Ben Wizner is a legal advisor to Edward Snowden. He's also the director of the Speech, Privacy, and Technology Project of the American Civil Liberties Union. He joins me now live from New York. Ben, thank you so much for joining us again here on CNN International. And again, 2 years ago today, that was when Snowden started to reveal the full scope of the NSA surveillance program. Did you ever imagine the impact those revelations would have today?
Candidly, I did not. And I think that Edward Snowden says it best in that op-ed piece that you showed that's published today around the world in many languages. This is the power of an informed public. When those stories first began to appear in June of 2013, the defense that we heard from U.S. officials, which was accurate, was that the programs that were being revealed had been approved by all three branches of the U.S. government, by an intelligence court, by the Congress, and by the executive. But look at what happens as soon as the public was brought into the conversation. All three branches of the U.S. government have reversed course. The president, who once defended some of these programs, has said they're not necessary. Congress has passed the first significant intelligence reform since the 1970s, and last month, the federal court in New York said that one of the programs had been illegal all along. I don't think any of this could have happened without these revelations.
The public is informed and the leaks just keep coming. Now we have newly published Snowden documents about cyber surveillance. These secret memos that allow the NSA to hunt on internet cables without a warrant and affecting Americans on American soil. Your thoughts on this latest leak and its significance?
Well, I want to clarify one thing. There's no ongoing series of leaks, as you described. These are all documents that were provided in June of 2013 by Edward Snowden to journalists. And the documents that are published today in the New York Times are actually from 2012. But I think this is a complicated story. The most important fact I would say here is that we shouldn't be finding out about this years later based on these disclosures. If the NSA, which is a foreign intelligence agency, is going to play this role of essentially scanning all internet traffic and storing information not just on foreigners but on American citizens, this is something that we ought to be debating publicly. There was nothing in this story that was a national security secret, and there's no reason that we should be reading about this years after this program was started in the New York Times instead of debating it as a democratic country.
And your thoughts about the so-called USA Freedom Act? I mean, it was a pretty huge leap for Congress to reform NSA surveillance programs. But is it, at the end of the day, a small step in what's needed for NSA reform?
You know, I would say that I have very mixed feelings about this. You know, on the one hand, I can't say in good faith that this one act of Congress is significant reform in the context of the threats that mass surveillance poses to free societies. On the other hand, it's really a watershed moment, at least in U.S. politics. This is the first time since the 1970s that Congress has acted to restrict rather than to expand the power of intelligence agencies to conduct surveillance. This would have been unthinkable years ago. It used to be, at least for the last decade since 9/11, that if national security officials said, we need this authority because of terrorism, legislators would jump or they would hide. And now we saw a bipartisan coalition in Congress stand up to those kinds of claims and allow facts to take precedent over fear-mongering. So I think that the fact that Congress did this is more significant than the details of the bill.
Got it. And another question for you, final one. The fate of Edward Snowden, is there a sense of growing momentum, a growing conversation there in the United States to allow Edward Snowden to return home?
You know, I hope so. I can't speak for government officials. I think that every day that goes by, every victory in the court, every change in Congress demonstrates that what he did in good faith, that his actions have served the public interest. I think that history generally is much kinder to whistleblowers than it is to overblown claims of national security. And it's really my hope that he won't spend the rest of his life in exile from the country that he loves.